In this topic, we're going to look at controlling access to subscriptions. So before we talk about that, you have to kind of make sure you understand why we can maybe have more than one subscription. Obviously, if I want to get into Azure, that's kind of a prerequisite. I have to create and have a subscription, but it is possible to have more than one. So think about a subscription as kind of a unit of billing. It's kind of like a way we can contain all the cloud services. So for example, we may have, I've worked with companies that acquire other companies, right? And so they may have inherited another subscription, or they may divest, or they may have other business units, or they may have different departments. And in those cases, they may have their own subscriptions, because although it's nice to have it all under one umbrella, just like an Active Directory, it's not always, you know, the politically preferred choice. So some, you know, departments, some sub-business units want to keep these things separate. So whether I have one or I have multiple subscriptions, now we need to control access to that. So there's different types of administrative roles. It's not really complex, but you just do need to understand the subtle differences between these. So we have these broken down here for you, and there's primarily three different accounts. But actually, before we talk about the different roles, you need to understand kind of an important concept here is that we have two different types of IDs that we can use. So we have user IDs, which can be Microsoft accounts or work or school accounts. Now, this is pretty important that you know, choose the right one on here. So as a general rule, what you want to do is use work or school accounts whenever you need to assign administrative access. And the reason why is when you do those are actually created in Azure, and you can then do something which I would recommend to do in Azure, which would be to enable multi-factor authentication. So if you're an administrator, you don't want them just logging in with a simple username and password. We want to really secure that and have two form factors. So username and password, and then my mobile app and Azure Authenticator app can authenticate me. And that's super, super simple to set up and configure. It's literally a switch of a button, a couple configuration options. And actually, by default, what's really nice is for Azure MFA, for some things it requires premium access, but get this, admins get it for free. So that's a nice bonus of being the administrator. Although your other users can't do it without premium, you as an administrator can. So that's a really nice bonus. So back to the different roles here. By default, if I set up a subscription, this is what's really neat. I then am also, by default, the service administrator. So you kind of get a two for one right there. And with that, so let's break these down specifically on each one. So as the account administrator, what is it that I can do? So I'm authorized to access the account center. So from there, I can create subscriptions, I can cancel it, I can change billing, I can see my billing. So let's actually take a look at this. I have mine fired up. And here's the link. So it's the account.windowsazure.com. And this is kind of a nice window because this actually gets us into the meat and potatoes of what these roles can do. So down here at the bottom, I have the account center, and then I also have the management portal. And of course, if I wanted to go to the newer preview, I'd go to portal.azure.com, but there's the old traditional manage.windowsazure.com. But since I'm the account administrator, I want to go into the account center. So I'm logged in as Mark Grimes, Microsoft.com, and I can come in here. And here I see, so I have my internal Microsoft Azure subscription, which I use. And give it a second to load up. There we go. So great. I have a current balance of $0. I love that. So we can download usage details. I can contact Microsoft support. I can edit subscription details. So if I come in here, I can look at various properties. So there's my name. There's my email address to update. And we're updating some of this in the new portal. And so we can change some of that. Also, we have partner information, or we could, you know, if you're done with this and we did a merger of organizations, we can actually cancel the subscription. And it gives me my administrator address and, of course, my subscription ID. All right. So the next administrator account, so we said by default, I'm a service administrator. So that is what we had back on the, when we were back on the portal and we logged in. So we're going to go to manage.windowsazure.com. We could do that. But once we get going, I want someone else. You always want to have a backup administrator, right? So I can create co-administrator. And the cool thing about this is that we can actually do up to 200 co-administrators. Now, of course, we wouldn't want that. You want to keep your concept of least privilege, have as few as possible. But in this way, apart from the account administrator, we can add additional co-administrators in there as well. So these are the three types of administrative roles we have. And again, as a best practice, you want to make sure you use work or school accounts so that then for those administrative accounts, you can do an additional form factor like MFA, multi-factor authentication, to help secure access. And then thus you can delegate responsibilities to additional administrators to help you out in your day-to-day task in managing Azure. So that concludes our topic on controlling access to subscriptions.